الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام رسول الكريم، أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May peace and mercy and blessing of Allah be upon you. Today my topic is, Was Islam separated by the sword? How can Islam be called the religion of peace when it was separated by the sword? It is a common complaint among some non-Muslims that Islam would not have millions of adherents all over the world if it had not been separated by the use of force. The following points will make it clear that far from being separated by the sword, it was the inherent force of truth, reason and logic that was responsible for the rapid separate of Islam. Islam means peace. Islam comes from the root word salam, which means peace. It also means submitting one's will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thus, Islam is a religion of peace, which is acquired by submitting one's will to the will of the Supreme Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometime, force has to be used to maintain peace. Each and every human being in this world is not in favor of maintaining peace and harmony. There are many who would disturb it for their own vested interest. Sometimes, force has to be used to maintain peace. It is precisely for this reason that we have the police, who use force against criminals and antisocial elements to maintain peace in the country. Islam promotes peace. At the same time, Islam exhorts its followers to fight where there is oppression and injustice. The fight against oppression and injustice may at times require the use of force. In Islam, force can only be used to promote peace and justice. Opinion of historian D. Leslie O'Leary. The best reply to the misconception that Islam was separated by the sword is given by the noted historian D. Leslie O'Leary in the book Islam at the Crossroad, page number 8. History makes it clear, however, that the legend of fanatical Muslims sweeping through the world and forcing Islam at the point of the sword upon conquered races is one of the most fantastically absurd myths that historians have ever repeated. Muslims ruled Spain for 800 years and did not use the sword to force the people to convert. Later, the Christian clusters came and drew out the Muslims. There was not a single Muslim left in Spain who could openly give the Adhan, the call to prayers. 14 million Arabs are apathetic Christians. Muslims were the lord of the Arabia for 1400 years. For a few years, the British ruled, and for a few years, the French ruled. Overall, the Muslims ruled Arabia for 1400 years. Yet, today, there are 14 million Arabs who are Coptic Christians i.e. Christians since generation. If the Muslims had used the sword, there would not have been a single Arab who would have remained a Christian. More than 80% non-Muslims in India. The Muslims ruled India for about 1,000 years. If they wanted, they had the power of converting each and every non-Muslim of India to Islam. Today, more than 80% of the population of India are non-Muslims. All these non-Muslim Indian are bearing witness today that Islam was not spread by the sword. Indonesia and Malaysia. Indonesia is a country that has the largest number of Muslims in the world. The majority of people in Malaysia are Muslims. One may ask, which Muslim army went to Indonesia and Malaysia? East coast of Africa. Similarly, Islam has spread repeatedly on the east coast of Africa. One may again ask, if Islam was spread by the sword, which Muslim army went to the east coast of Africa? No compulsion in religion. With which sword was Islam spread? Even if Muslims had it, they could not use it to spread Islam, because the Quran says in the following verse, let there be no compulsion in religion. Truth stands out clear from error. Al-Quran 2.256. Sword of the intellect. It is the sword of intellect, the sword that conquers the hearts and minds of people. The Quran says in Surah Nahl, chapter 16, verse 125. Invite all to the way of your Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching, and argue with them in ways that are best and most gracious. Al-Quran 16.125. Subhanallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.